Hi, welcome to Everything X-Carve. I'm Brian, and today we're going to install the OptLaser PLH 3D 6-Watt XF Plus laser for your X-Carve. Hi, I'm Brian with Everything X-Carve, and today we're going to be doing the install of the OptLaser PLH 3D 6-Watt XF Plus laser. So far, after doing the unboxing, which was in the last video, everything is really impressive. I've got it all laid out here. Everything's polished aluminum. It's shiny. I think that just adds to it. Really cool looking. I like the fact that they've got the long extension cord for it to go in through the chain here on the X-Carve and then have still some excess room to play with. So with that being said, we'll go ahead and we're going to follow the user manual to get this thing set up the way it should be. To get the setup instructions, it's very easy. All you have to do is take a picture of the QR code with the instructions that came in your box, or you can go to the OptLaser site, go to the X-Carve laser upgrades page, and then click downloads. That's going to take you down to where they have movies, downloads, articles, and then manuals. You're going to want to click on the X-Carve CNC upgrade manual. What that's going to do is it's going to download a PDF for you to open up. Once that's downloaded, this will take you right into the index and the introduction parts, basic safety, technical data, and then the setup on how to install this. Now, this is where I also was able to go to Thingiverse and print out different mounting solutions for my X-Carve spindle and the OptLaser. So check that out. It might actually help you, especially if you have access to a 3D printer. And then it just walks through all of the different setups. Now I will let you know that the brain that you get obviously is not going to be that. That's an older version. They've since upgraded it quite significantly. But it looks very easy. And then the software setup, we'll get into that later. There are some things that you do need to do within the easel software under the advanced settings for the machine inspector. Make sure that you've got a fire extinguisher. I went out and bought that specifically for the laser, even though I probably should have had it already for the X-Carve. This is something you never want to leave unattended. Mind you, you're burning something with a laser beam. Probably not the best idea to walk away from it. So when you are operating a laser, always make sure that you are present. And if you are going to have someone else out with you with the laser, buy another set of goggles. I did. They're on their way right now, identical to the OptLasers. They're $45 to $55. I think they're $55 through OptLasers. It might be a lot of money for protection safety glasses, but you're dealing with a laser here. It's always better to be safe than sorry, especially with the radiation that's coming off. You don't want to burn your retinas. First thing we want to do is take our docking station and get that locked into place. Now with this, down below here, you'll see a couple different sets of screws. The screws that we're going to be focusing on are right here. Now, the reason why you've got more screws here is because it's not just a kit for the X-Carve. I believe this also has Shapeoko parts in it, so that way, should you maybe even switch machines, you've already got the parts for that, which is a nice to have. Never opposed to having any extra screws laying around when you need them. So then we'll put them up here. You wanna do this on the bottom two. However, it is set to where you could do it for all three. I'm gonna do it down to the bottom two.
can just screw that in. Screw the other one in. The next part is to take this, which is the docking station, and connect that to your mount. Now, what'll happen is it'll sit just like this to where your cord is facing against, away from you, and you'll just screw that in there. And it screws in with only two screws up against here. And we'll do that now.
The next part of the process is to get the other half of the docking station mounted to the laser. And that's fairly easy. It's just four screws into your laser, and then you can magnetically connect it to the docking station attached to the spindle. All right, so you've got two different sets of screws here now. You've got these small ones here, and those are gonna go into the recessed holes here. And then your longer ones are gonna go here. And the reason for that is having the longer one, what it's going to do is it's only going to allow the laser to be facing one way, and that'll be straight down. If these weren't on there, the laser could be pointed somewhere other direction, and that's a huge safety risk. So it will only connect with the five pins if it's facing down, and that's, you know, just as a safety precaution. You never want it going anywhere other than one direction. Get this screwed down and recessed in. All right, so as it stands, this is on and this is on. Now we should be able to connect it magnetically to see if it'll work to put it on and off. So what we'll do here is we'll just give it a go. And there you go. That is awesome. It's staying there. Now we need to do the wire up. And that shouldn't take too long to do. So now what we'll do is we'll take this back off and we'll connect the part here that's supposed to go on. We'll put the cover where it should be when it's not in use. Okay, so looking at the instructions, you want to have the white. You want to have the white facing on the outside, facing your right when you put it in. So make sure that it looks like this when putting it in. And now that's connected. And it does come off very easily. So there is no locking mechanism in there. And then next you'll put this up top like so, to where your white is now facing on the left-hand side for the laser itself. Now what we need to do is we need to run the laser head cable down the gantry, down the drag chain. That way we can have our laser box sit up here on top of the X controller. Now you're gonna wanna grab a screwdriver and you're gonna have to pop these off. Now, the only time I've ever done this was installing the machine.
When we put this in, let me drop that down so you can see this here. When we do this, you're gonna wanna sneak it back behind the router. There's a little spot right here between the spindle wheels. That's where I'd put it. Now granted, cable's a little hard to do that with it right here. So what I would recommend is loosening this up a little bit here on this side to allow your gantry to get that cabling behind your gantry. So we're gonna do that right now, actually, which is not something that's in the guide, but I think it's definitely worth taking the extra time and then get her connected. All right, so you can see brown wires on top. You want to make sure you've got that oriented. And then put your screw, put your cabling behind these screws here. And then on the other side, make sure it's down below there as well. Push back down your spindle. That way you're locking your spindle back down. That looks right. Okay, so your cable's in. You still got some play here. You don't want to put too much pull there. And then what I've seen people do is feed it back through, and that's what we'll do. We'll follow suit there. All in all, very simple to do. You just got to make sure that you're following the instructions. All right, so this is where I'm gonna put my op laser controller, just right on top of the X-Carve X controller. That way everything as far as control and lockout is all right here. So what we'll do is, I've put Velcro on the back. I'm just gonna take these off. So the next step is we wanna take this wiring and just stick it in there. And the only way you can do that is just push it in. Now, you've got all this extra cable, so you're gonna wanna figure where to put that before you push that down in, because you've gotta tuck this away. So I'm gonna tuck mine away down in that little hole there. And then I'm gonna feed it back underneath here. So that way I've got enough space to where I'm not cramping it and crowding it, but still can do that. So I'm gonna feed that through there. All right, and then we're just gonna plug it in. All right. All right, so that's plugged in there. We're good there. Now the next step is to take your signal wire, which is right here, and you're gonna plug that in on this side, and then down here with your PWN, which is your third one, and that's spindle PWN, and your ground. And what I've done is I've marked the ground here as orange, and the PWN is purple, and we'll put those in there. With all this extra wire, do the same thing you did last time. Put it down there. That way you don't have, you've got all your area here, your cable management somewhat clean. So plug this in down here. Okay, so that's in. Then feed back your wire. All you need to do now is plug it in here. And it's only gonna be able to go one way. So once you get that in there, locked in, that's it. From here to here, your laser is now wired.
Now that the hardware is all complete, now we move on to the software setup. There's some things that we need to do into Easel to change that, specifically going into the machine inspector and adding a few additional codes. So the next step is to get into your machine inspector. By doing this, you'll need to make sure that your X controller is on, so that way it can pull the Griebel settings, and we will go up to machine in Easel, go to Advanced, and click on Machine Inspector. At this point in time, you can see all the codes that are going on in your machine. You're gonna wanna go down to Settings, and you're gonna wanna copy, and then paste these into a notepad.
Right, so The next step is to turn your laser on and get it ready to fire. So you're gonna wanna turn your key on. Laser is got power. Now we're gonna arm it. You can hear the fan kicking in. And the next step after this is to put the code in into your console settings.
Make sure you're on the console piece of your settings here. And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna paste $32 equals zero and then press enter. Here's where you do the M3 space S1 and hit enter. As you can see, that's gonna fire your laser. It is at its lowest power. And then what you'll do is you'll hit M5 and that'll deactivate the laser. So you've just successfully ensured that your laser is good to go. What we need to do next is put back in under the console code, $32 equals one. And the reason for this is the spindle, the laser shouldn't fire unless the axis is moving. So what we've done is we've just turned that code back on to say that the laser will not be able to fire unless it is moving by using that $32 equals one. The next thing we need to do is configure your X controller with the laser itself by putting in three different codes in the console settings. The first one is $30 equals 1000. What this does is that's telling the maximum spindle speed versus at an RPM, and then $31 equals zero is maximum spindle speed, and then $32 equals one is laser mode enable boolean. So with this, the laser won't fire unless it is moving now, because the laser mode alters the output based on the feed rate.
All right, so you got your shiny new keys to your shiny new toy. It's all set up, ready to go. Now we need to find our software solution. So what we're gonna do is in the next video, we're gonna do just that. We're gonna pick our software for the machine and we're gonna get that set up. And then we're gonna do our test laser, our first test fire outside of Easel with the software itself. So if you've been here before, you know what's up next. If you like what you saw, consider giving it a thumbs up. If you want to see more, consider subscribing. And don't forget to check out our Everything X-Carve Facebook group. There's thousands of people literally in there ready to help you out. In addition, there's even an Opt Lasers Facebook group. Go check them out as well. I'll make sure I link that down into the description. Stay tuned for what's coming up next. Thanks for watching.